is disconnected from the truck or the vehicle.
Is that setting you back up?
Yeah. We don't know what. I'm going to in a minute.
See, all of us start running, then you know you're in trouble.
We're not precisely sure what's going to transpire here. Or is that what we're doing?
All right, somebody come here and watch this bubble. You stay on the hand crank.
Okay.
Oh, that's why we just connected.
Yes.
All right, I'm going to go up or down?
I don't know. We got to find where the bubble needs to go. Go down.
I don't see the bubble at all. So. See anything?
Keep going. There, I see the edge of it. See the edge of this one. Okay, ho, go the other way about. Now, I know we're off level like this, so go back up just a little bit.
Back up, okay.
I should have brought another level.
Yeah,
okay, so. Right there. All right. Now, who wants to be the guinea? Yeah, I know. We're off this one. I can adjust that, except I didn't bring a level for something else.
I see what you're talking about now. You're.
All right. And this is where I say this gets to be irritating, because you got to take this loose. Somebody left that. Swing this to its approximately 45 degrees.
45 degrees from where?
Oh, from this surface right here. And these are
tight. Keep going.
Okay. I mean, these are tight.
Oh, yeah. Undo those.
That makes it a lot easier.
Yeah. Somebody remember that in the notes.
Hey, Nick, come over here on the port side.
What?
Come here on the port side.
I don't know, sailor. Port side. What the hell is port side?
Hey, 90.
45. I'll tell you why you don't do 90.
Okay. All right, mark that down. 45 degrees, Holly.
I did.
Close enough. take that loose. Slide it up. Okay. But you're still gonna need all of them. So.
Take this loose.
Yeah. Take that loose. You may have to wrench. Luckily, it's an ordinary piece of pipe.
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. Actually, that pipe's banging up.
Did you start it upside down?
I did. Pushed it too far now, I think.
Yep. Important. Now, the 45 degrees or more, don't put it ever out like this. Because you might get some idiot like I did one day, or Buddy Sorrell. Society's going to climb this thing. Guess what?
It tipped over backwards.
Yes. Okay. Not very far, because it don't take you long to get off of it.
Yeah.
That go in there.
That's bent. That's seriously bent.
Yeah. That's the one that's bent.
Yeah.
Okay. We don't need this one as much as we do the other. All right. Those two outriggers, in your case, the one on this side, somebody get back here and just stand and look at it and say, hey, about level.
These need to be tight.
Yep. Here's what I'm going to do is attempt to level this thing. I'm going to tighten this teeth.
Oh, okay.
Not the best way to do it. You know, best way is on level ground. But
I can drop this a little bit then.
Well, we don't go anywhere that has level ground.
Yeah.
anything level in Kentucky is right. That's all right. Just tighten her down.
There you go, okay.
Because you're not going to do anything. All right. Who's going to be using this thing? All you can do is right here on these.
Okay.
Loosen them up. The J hook.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And turn them.
Great point.
All right. Now.
Can we take the signal indicator off?
Yeah, I would, because it's going to definitely get dirty.
Oh, I put another turn J hooks up top.
I did.
All right.
Not far enough yet, bud.
These I need loose.
Okay.
You notice what I'm doing here? These two in the back, loosen.
Okay.
The only reason is, when that comes down, it's going to come down on those two pins, and you're going to go, I got to get them loose.
All right.
Okay, so they got to come all the way out then.
No, just tell you.
Just so they're not touching.
Yeah, so that the pins can slide in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
can you see how it threw up there? Okay. Who's the young energetic person that wants to crank this thing?
I think that would be Nick.
Yeah.
Well, you two
10 motor oil, like 10 weight.
Okay, all right.
I'm looking to see what else is.
Okay. All right.
He didn't leave the J hook tied.
All right, J hook's undone.
This is undone. Start cranking.
All right. Which, right?
Don't worry about it. You'll figure it out real quick.
Everything does.
Hey, Bud.
Yeah, I got it.
But I was thinking there was more surface area this thing, but, you know,
it's going to get easier. In fact,
if we had a... You're wasting time looking at the recording on it. No, it's looking. Okay.
I guarantee you it's not going to line up perfect, but,
well, I
get going.
Like most things in life, it's an experiment, huh?
Perfect.
It didn't line up perfect, but it sure went on there.
It did.
So we need to tighten those.
Is it vertical? To the best of your ability? Looks like
it. Looks like it.
I mean, guys, if I wanted to get technical with this, I'd carry me a 2 or 3 foot level.
Okay.
So that you can be sure it's level this way, make sure this is plumb.
Okay.
All right, tighten these down.
Plumb and level, okay?
Yep. Plumb and level. All right.
Okay.
Now, the electronics don't work, I can tell you that.
On that one, sorry.
Because they've had too many bugs and other stuff in them over the years. But look. This little hand crank right here. Pull the pin out. Don't lose the pin. Come on. Good old military. Go back here and put this hand crank on the back here.
Oh, let me go over here.
Okay, so there's only one hand crank.
There's only one hand crank, which is a good thing. It's always secured to something. Now, if anybody's got a lot of time and wants to go through all these relays and switches, this thing works great electrically too.
Well, we're going to do that.
Is the motor still in good shape?
Yeah. Last time I used it, it was, but the problem was, well, I finally got the switch box from the guy I got it from. He shipped it to me. And after that, we never run it to the 40-foot level, so. But
actually, where's it at right now? What is that? It's almost
20.
That looks 20 feet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, basically what I'm going to tell you is 90% of the time, definitely need some lubrication.
Yeah, let's go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead if you want to get it.
Yeah,
but don't go for
40
feet. We don't want to spend all.
Yeah.
That's it.
Where does this need to be at?
Don't spray that. That's your brake.
That's your brake. Okay.
Don't spray that. Because when he lets that down, I want somebody on that brake.
Okay.
That provides friction to the.
That's right.
Go ahead, Nick. Because I just sprayed that up there, by the way. So.
No, it's not. I mean,
moving like an inch a minute.
Don't worry, it gets faster.
Oh, does it?
Yeah, because as you move each section out, the cable gets shorter and moves the other sections up.
My foot. Okay. Oh, shoot. Right there. See if you can get a... Take your thin end of it. That's what I did was this right here. All right. Now, hold that. Back a little more.
You need some over there?
No, because he's going to let go of that just as quick as... Is it coming at all, guys?
Yeah, it's coming down.
Yeah, it's something moving.
Yeah. I'm wondering why we got so much. Well, like I said, it hadn't been used in 3 years, so we still break.
Oops.
You stopped me. But that's what you got. That's the trick right now with doing
manually.
Okay. Now, here, I'll hold it. You get in there. Ah, I'll hold it. Where is that sweet spot?
Right? I think we need a newer model. Coat hangers with
yeah. All right. Pull her back. Okay. All right. See, okay. My handle's hitting every time I come around. This probably is.
So now you're lowering it?
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, isn't that what the brake is? Wouldn't the brake hold that open as well?
No, it won't hold that open.
It won't hold that ratchet open?
No. This electric solenoid's what held it, right?
Oh, okay.
Are we coming down?
Yeah. We're coming down, yeah. I'm watching this, and this is coming down.
Don't get your finger in there.
Yeah.
You can see that coming down, though.
Oh, you're putting your note pinch
points. It's okay to put your head in there to look up, but don't get your finger in there.
All
right. Yeah, there is.
I mean, the nice thing is we're only about 10 feet up in the air, so it's... If you pull that all the way up and pull that brake, it'll come down. You don't want to have a hold of this handle at that time.
No, we don't want that.
No.
We don't want that kind of energy.
It'll get the rust loose.
Yeah.
Yeah, and probably give you a busted nose or some teeth, or maybe a broken arm.
It just gives you. Gives you a real fright.
Yeah. Let Don.
Well, the hardest part's getting by that.
No video.
I wonder if it'd even be a good idea to mandate helmets around here.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I guarantee you, when I set it up with Buddy,
down, aren't
yeah. I always wore hard hats.
I'm going the right direction.
Because he's been known to carry a wrench up there and drop it.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Right.
But, yeah, it needs a bunch of grease. It needs a lot of work.
That's a fine piece of
equipment. Oh, yeah.
It just needs a little...
Needs a little TLC.
Yeah.
I mean, it's been around over 30 years up in this area, back and forth.
Where did it come from originally? Do you know?
All I know is one of the guys that lived up on Brooks Hill when we had the old 7-0 repeater over in the middle of Brooks Hill.
Mm-hmm.
He had it, and he died, or before he died, Fred Amos bought it. We kept it for a while, took it down to Center, Kentucky, and Fred's father-in-law put it in the barn for 10 years, and I hauled it home about 6 years ago. And
do you have any pressure on that from the...
No. You can see the...
Whoa. There you're good. Take up slack a little
bit. Take up slack.
Sorry.
That's all right.
It's all the way down now.
It's all the way down.
Okay. All right. Tell me when to stop.
Any questions, that's
good.
Please?
That's good.
Okay.
Note taker, questions?
Most important thing is don't lose the coat hanger.
Or have a replacement.
I don't.
So where do you wire in on that?
I
want
her to
stick
it.
What?
Electric?
Yeah.
Here?
Here?
No, I took it to the
switch box right there, right? Right? Here's the electric. And I would say...
And they gave me the wire brush and walk up touch.
They would probably go up.
I've tested the handles.
All right, that ought to be loosened up.
Nick, winch man. Up there.
And somebody to back him up.
Oh, no, up there.
Up there, okay.
Can you grab mine the brakes? I need a wrench man, brake man, and a winch man.
Okay.
So two people take this up as trailer, it looks like.
For safety, yes.
Yeah.
I mean, honestly and truly, it's probably not going to get away from him. It's going to take him a little bit of effort to get it going.
Okay, because of the weight?
Oh, yeah.
Would it help if I move things?
Well, it would help if you got on a hold of it and just pulled.
I don't think the T-bar on this side must not be all the way
out. T-bar's loose?
They're all loose, yeah.
Nah, you got to back it out. You got to back it out almost all the way. Okay. Am I going the wrong direction?
Pull that up.
Is it gonna go? All right, stop. Why stop? All right. Now, somebody hold that. And the thing is, your reaction is, if anything goes wrong, you let that pin drop. Okay? Now, pull it out. Now start cranking. The only bad thing is, if you react quicker than he thinks about it, his arms are gonna come to a real quick stop. We're not going to let that happen.
It's not going to. It doesn't move violently, but.
Oh, you're moving the chain now. Okay.
Yeah.
Any effort, Harmon?
Okay, no. How can we do something?
Once we disengage the ratchet here,
okay.
My trusty assistant here.
You got a brake over there. He's holding the brake and he's holding that pin.
Yeah.
You let go
there you go. That's better. Back.
Yeah, okay. It's okay to lose an arm, but not a head.
No, don't lose anything.
Is your hand out of the way on that?
Because you're not putting any effort into it. The biggest effort you're going to have now is when it comes over center, and it's going to get real easy on you.
Yeah, so I need to apply a little pressure on this to slow the speed down.
He's got the much hole on it. It's not going to move that fast.
I'll do the trailer.
It's almost down, really.
So if I were to say brake or stop, you just let everything go.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right? Let's try it. Stop. Stop.
You can't do anything.
Yeah. Okay. So, but you also want to pull this, too.
You'd like to. Yeah. But if you do that, it's going to stop.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's a safety procedure. Everybody got that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's the reason it's that away. Spring loaded.
Who's in charge down here, him or him?
He is. Okay. He's cranking. He's going to go, give me a break, and all he's got to do is let go of it.
I would say our rope rescue command is stop.
Okay. We're doing the same rope rescue.
So really, you don't need to have this brake.
No, you don't need that brake.
You should
but it's nice to know where it is. And,
yeah.
Okay. So is it centered?
Okay. Oh, don't worry. It's down.
You can let it go.
Put the J's back on it.
Put the J hooks on it.
Okay.
No. Push them up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Thread it out there.
All right.
So you can get enough room to turn it. Turn the J.
Now, back here in the back.
Wait a minute. Okay, yeah.
Back here in the back, tighten these two T-bars up so you don't lose them.
Okay. Now, does it bother anybody underneath here?
No, they got.
Oh, don't worry.
It's hooked down there, so it's not going to come down.
I mean, the safety aspect of it is.
Well, yes.
Where am I? Don't need
OSHA would tell you to stand to the side.
Okay.
But we could probably put four people on there, and it probably wouldn't budge them J hooks.
Okay. Now, how?
All the way till they won't fall out, bouncing down the road 60 mile an hour.
Seems much lower than it was at James's, wasn't it?
It can't be any lower. You got a piece of T-bar up there.
No, that's what I'm wondering.
Well.
Because I can reach this now.
Well, we've still got our pose if we raise it up from that or something.
All right. As soon as he gets these done, take these outriggers and turn them in.
Undo the yellow. Before you move the outriggers, you got to loosen those.
Yeah.
Loosen the T's at the top there.
T's right here.
Oh, I'm sorry. Holly, give me a tractor triangle.
A tractor triangle?
What do you call them?
A slow-moving vehicle sign.
A level with the made a shape of a triangle?
No, just a reflector in back here.
One of those reflectors.
Oh, it did have one on there.
Well, it is, but it's like lost its reflectivity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Remember, the antennas on them. All right, who's the guy asking about where we put the antenna?
That'd be him.
I thought this was for Wi-Fi service.
Well, it could be.
I'm just going to strap my puck to it, and that's what I'm going to do.
If you strap your puck to that, you should get at least 300 foot of range. Because when we had the puck or the antenna on the Red Cross ECRV, we figured 300 foot of range with antenna at 60
feet. That's the question I was going to call a Y hook.
Can I borrow that for a minute?
Sure.
What is this for?
It actually had a rotor system on it when the military had it.
I don't know where it went. It was the
anemometer pointed north. Now, 1940s, they didn't have the way to calibrate them. Now we do have the way to calibrate them. Now, you going to try to straighten it?
No, I was just going to put it somewhere. Okay.
Yeah.
That's where it's been.
I didn't know where it was. It was laying here, so I didn't know.
That's where it's been.
I can't get this turned anymore. I need a... Yeah.
Now, does this require guy wires?
No.
Okay.
If I was going to set it up at 40 feet for a long period of time, then I'd be putting guy wires on it.
Okay.
With cables or can it be rope or something?
Well, yeah, but you want something that...
Oh, the other question. Right there, aren't you? Grounding.
Grounding?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
No, I mean,
that's easy.
I don't need it real
Marco, tight. Can you comprehend that grounding?
Well, this one's going to go...
Is it going to be... Something, copper wire in the ground or what?
Oh, it's going to be a piece of three-quarter inch pipe, minimum. Or if you want to spend a lot of money, go buy a copper rod.
You were trying to do it the right way.
It's dependent
Make sure hand on that wrench when you're done with it, because I think those need to be really tight, because a lot of bouncing will just loosen those up.
And also, you want to put that one up as far as it'll go.
Yeah.
So in case we hit some high ground
sure
or something.
Tighten everything down. But as far as ground wires,
That good? I mean, now pull that one up as far as it'll go.
What did you do to get it up before?
Well, I pulled on this.
There we go.
Okay.
There we are.
It just looks like it's twisted a touch, whatever it is.
Yeah, that did the trick. Thank you, sir.
And as you already know, I'm not as strong as you are, so.
Here you go.
It was right there.
That is how you do it.
This is how we
do it. I was thinking the same thing.